Hello there guys, it's Pixion, and today we are going to be using the free digital audio workstation Ardour and the free software sampler TX16Wx that you can download as a VST plugin. We're going to be using these together to load in drum samples and play around with them using our MIDI keyboard here and potentially record some things. So we're going to jump right into it by opening Ardour, and we're going to create a new session and call it sampler setup. Yeah, just gonna jump right into it here, like I said. And what we're gonna do first is just create a new MIDI track. And before I go much further, I'm gonna assume that you have a basic understanding of how to use Ardour and how to perform various functions and do certain things. But if you don't, let me know in the comments below, and I can always create another tutorial that's a little bit more in depth, or I can point you towards some resources that are going to help you out a little more. So we're going to create a new track, and it's going to be a MIDI track, and the instrument that we're going to choose is just going to be our simple synth. This should be built in with your copy of Ardour, I think, regardless of platform, but I believe TX16WX is only on Windows, so just something to keep in mind. So we're going to create this and just hit add and close, hit add here. And now we're going to have this new hi-hat track with our simple synth here. And we are going to assign it to our Impulse, which is my MIDI controller here. And if you don't have this cool little window on the left side of your screen like mine, you can hit Shift-E. And it will open up the editor mixer, which is super useful for when you want to edit individual tracks. So we're gonna jump in here, and we're gonna I'm gonna jump into my favorites, but you might have to use the plugin manager, and we're gonna navigate to TX16WX and add it in our stack underneath our simple synth, but above our fader. And the reason that is because TX16WX doesn't function as an instrument by itself. It needs an input, and the general MIDI synth that's created by default with tracks, that one doesn't work properly with TX16WX for whatever reason. So just create the simple synth and use that as the input source for this. But we're going to jump into our file browser here, and we're going to navigate to a sample I want to use for this, and we're just going to drag it over to our actual piano roll here. And I've already set this track to be assigned to the Impulse MIDI controller I have. So because I have a custom mapping already set as well, when I press the pad here, the corresponding note is going to be reflected up there for me. So I can go ahead and just assign this sample just to this pad, set the trigger to one shot, and the scale to fixed. And the reason I do that is because with the trigger set to one shot, whenever this pad is hit, it will play the entirety of the sample. And the scale being set to fixed means regardless of what note you set the sample to play, when triggered, it's gonna play at its normal, normal pitch without any, without being any octaves or semitones higher or lower. So that makes it really, really useful for just laying down beats. So at this point, I'm going to jump into our wave editor. And because I know these samples from this pack are generally quieter than most, I'm going to jump in, right click here in the wave field, and normalize this. I'm going to zoom in some, drag our end to be a little bit closer here. Zoomed in a little much. We're going to zoom in and make sure our start is where the actual start of the sample begins, so we don't get a weird little delay. And now, boom, plays just fine. So with that being done, what we can go ahead and do is go back to our keyboard mapper and make sure everything's set properly. Lovely. And that is setting up one of our samples using TX16WX. So I can go ahead and close that window. And we're going to create a new track. Same deal, and we're just going to call this one Snare. I'm going to leave it as the simple synth because that's what's going to act as our input for TX. We're going to go ahead and select this. Make sure we drag it up in our stack. Select our impulse. And jump into the file browser. And we're going to navigate into these samples that we want right now. You know what? I know I don't want these samples. And I know some of these might be a little bit loud. Cool. So we're going to set it to just play on this note here, which is assigned to the pad I'm hitting. And we're going to make sure we set our trigger to one shot and our scale to fixed. Boom. So we already got that set up. So if you wanted to, for instance, start recording, what you can do is drag out your track here. And we're going to arm our track. And we're going to make sure we arm the actual recording. And if we were to hit play here, and this is really simple. We haven't messed with our BPM. We didn't even turn on our metronome or anything. But what we're going to do is just play that back. Boom. And I mean, it works just fine. There's no issue there. Not the greatest sample in the world, but it gives you an idea. And, you know, if you wanted to just arm the snare down here, and you could arm them both at the same time and delete this track, because since both of these tracks are both assigned to the impulse and they're both enabled, and they're assigned to different, you know, pads which function as different notes, you can record at the same time and play a melody if you wanted to, or, you know, play a drum line or whatever it is. So, that wasn't the greatest timing, and Ardour does have a quantizing feature to put your notes played on beat, but we're not going to use that for now. If we were to just go and play this back. Boom. See, so it is there. It does work just fine. So that's something that you can use, or something you can do. Boom. So, I mean, that's kind of how I set up my samplers. You can use other samplers such as Grace. Grace does work just fine. I just found that TX16Wx as a sampler. I prefer the interface. I feel like it gives me a little more control. And things just seem easier to accomplish within the sampler rather than Grace. But with, you know, everything like that being said, that's pretty much it, guys. So this tutorial is all done. Thank you guys for watching. It's been Pixion. And if you guys have any questions or anything like that, let me know down in the comments below. You know, if I went over anything too fast or there was just something that you didn't quite understand, let me know, and I'll either make a more in-depth tutorial based on that, or I can point you, you know, towards some resources that can help you out. But with that being said, guys, have a good one. I will catch you later. Peace.